bout, proudly brought to you by Budweiser. Your referee to this contest, once again, is Leo Christel. And now, introducing first, boxing out of the red corner to my left, wearing red and gold and weighing in a trim ready, 127¾ pounds, a veteran of 17 professional bouts. He comes to us from Austin, Texas. He's welcome, Carlos Tremendo Trevino. And his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner to my right, wearing black and silver, and entering the ring, undefeated, 4-0, three big wins by way of knockout. He comes to us from New Haven, Connecticut. His welcome, the undefeated, William, the Silent Assassin, Foster Butler.
Six rounds of boxing scheduled in the junior lightweight division between the undefeated Connecticut product William Foster III taking on Austin, Texas's Carlos Trevino. Peter Zimbo calling the action from Memorial Hall in Melrose, Massachusetts. This one scheduled for six rounds. It will be William Foster III wearing the black trunks and Trevino wearing the red trunks. This is a very significant fight in the career of William Foster III, more significant than you might think it is just looking at it on paper. He is trained by Louis Rosa Sr. and managed by Marilyn Rosa, who is Louis Rosa Sr.'s wife. Less than 2 weeks ago, their son, William Foster's friend and training partner, Louis Rosa Jr., tragically passed away in an automobile accident. This fight is dedicated to the memory of Louis Rosa Jr. He was the kingpin at the Boxing and Faith Gym in New Haven, Connecticut. Guys like William Foster III always looked up to him. Let's see what kind of performance William Foster III can put up tonight in honor and in memory of his friend, Louis the KO King Rosa. And I think that I speak for everyone in the close New England boxing community when I say that it's nice to see Louis Rosa Sr. and Marilyn Rosa back ringside tonight as they have fighters on this show after dealing with the unimaginable that happened less than 2 weeks ago. You seldom will find more dignified class people than Louis Rosa Sr. and Marilyn Rosa. Nice work upstairs by William Foster III. William Foster III, when we last saw him, looked scintillating against Dante Bryant from Michigan in a stoppage performance against the guy who had previously gone the distance and been very competitive with Ray Moylette, a highly touted prospect signed to Murphy's Boxing. I think that speaks to how talented William Foster III is. Referee Leo Gristel warns him about a left hand that's straight a tad low. Nice right hand by William Foster III. William Foster's brother Charles Foster, the unbeaten light heavyweight, who will be in action February 24th at Mohegan Sun Casino. We've seen him time and time again here on Murphy's Boxing broadcasts. Closing seconds of round one. Good opening frame for William Foster here at Memorial Hall in Melrose. And a nice right hand he landed in the closing seconds of round one. Trevino getting a little arrogant towards the end of round one, but no reason for him to be arrogant. He did not win that opening frame. Tell you right now, Memorial Hall here in Melrose, Massachusetts is buzzing right now. The crowd has been hot the entire evening, and the anticipation is building for the All-New England Showdown in the main event, which will be an eight-round fight for the New England Junior Middleweight Championship between defending champion Greg the Villain Vendetti of nearby Stoneham, Mass., and Beverly, Massachusetts, Derek Silvera. The crowd's buzzing about that. Who am I kidding? I'm buzzing about that one. That's going to be an excellent fight. Very much anticipated here tonight. This is the first of three shows to kick off the first quarter of 2018 for Murphy's Boxing. They're staying pretty active. I'll give them that. Three shows in 3 months. Most active boxing promoter in New England. Round two of the scheduled six-rounder. Nice body work by William Foster III. Very composed in there for a youngster as Foster. Looks like he ate a right hand there, but didn't seem fazed by it whatsoever. Not only is William Foster very calm, cool, and collected and composed in the ring, but very slick. He's not taking too much punishment, if at all. I think he's only been hit flush once the entire fight by my count. Well, I'll make that twice as a lead left just kind of hit him in the grill, but once again, not fazed. Round two coming to a conclusion between William Foster and Trevino, and I've got Foster ahead 2-0 as this one is scheduled for six. Moments ago, I misspoke when I was talking about Murphy's Boxing being the most active promoter in New England. I said they have three shows scheduled in the first quarter of 2018. I take that back. They have four shows, including this one, scheduled in the first quarter of 2018. This one tonight at Memorial Hall in Melrose. February 24th, Murphy's Boxing will be running at Mohegan Sun Casino. March 17th, St. Patrick's Day, Murphy's Boxing will be running at the House of Blues, right across from Fenway Park in Boston. And then 2 weeks later, at the Marina Bay Sportsplex in Quincy, Murphy's Boxing will be presenting an ESPN nationally televised fight card, which will feature the first title defense of WBA NABA North American Junior Middleweight Champion Mark the Italian Bazooka DeLuca of Whitman, Massachusetts, coming off a very impressive performance late last year against Anthony Link at Plain Ridge Park Casino. So Mark DeLuca looking to take another step in the right direction as he, one would think, be on the world scene within the next 12 months or so if his career keeps going on the trajectory that it is. In another Murphy's Boxing product, Gary Spike O'Sullivan coming off a KO win on HBO against Antoine Douglas last month. Rumor is that he is perhaps in line for a WBA world title shot against Danny Jacobs later on this year. If that, in fact, is the case, it would be quite the opportunity for Spike. And he's a guy that rose to the occasion in his most recent fight that he was not favored to win. So he'll be coming to fight. I don't think he can count him out, that's for sure. Carlos Trevino taking a good punch here in round three, I'll tell you that much. I think William Foster gave him a little love tap there on the break. Nice right hand by Foster. There was a nice right hand by Foster, but then oncoming fire from Trevino missed by a mile as Foster was able to avoid the punches. Nice right hand by Foster, followed by a nice left hand. Certainly finding his mark here in round three against Trevino. And a little bit of a warning from referee Leo Gerstel in the closing seconds of round three. I saw some blood go flying. I'm not sure whose blood it was, but I think it was Trevino's. And that blood appears to be coming from Trevino's nose. And the doctor is up in the ring taking a look at him. Round four, and William Foster on the attack from the get-go, and he's going to get warned by referee Leo Gerstel, I think, about some punches perhaps straying low. Good action here in round four. Oh. Beautiful work upstairs from William Foster. William Foster looking scintillating. One positive thing I can say about Trevino, despite the fact he's clearly lost every round so far, does not appear physically discouraged. His body language indicates he's still in there to fight. But through four, I have this one 4-0 in favor of Foster. Be interesting to see if the accumulation of punches from Foster can break down. And you know what? As I say that, the corner of Trevino says no more. The cumulative effects broke down the spirit of his corner, who did not want to see their man take any more punishment. I hope Luis Rosa Jr. is looking down smiling. William Foster with a fifth round TKO over Carlos Trevino here tonight in Melrose, Massachusetts. And he looked like the well-schooled fighter that he is, coming from the Boxing and Faith gym in New Haven, Connecticut. And I'll say this about the corner of Trevino. Your man hasn't won a single round yet. It's round five. He's getting the tar kicked out of him. The best thing you can say is that he's not backing down. I saw nothing through the first four-plus rounds of boxing we just witnessed to indicate to me that Trevino was capable of scoring a knockout win and winning this fight. So what was the purpose of it continuing? He was just going to take more punishment. I think that's a corner that cares for their fighter.
Let's
William Foster III, now 5-0 with four knockouts, and appears to have a bright career ahead of him.